Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video on the MasterGrade, you'll learn about the printer light shortcuts in the Flame 2019.2 update. For those of you who may not know, printer lights go back to the old photochemical days before digital color. They were measured in points, and the idea was that you could add or subtract exact amounts of red, green, and blue light in order to change the color balance within a given shot. With celluloid film, technicians used filtered red, green, and blue light, but nowadays, you perform the same operation digitally within an application. This may be considered as a basic grading tool, but it is very powerful because of the adjustment precision that is more accurate than using the mouse or a pen and tablet. This video is not footage specific, so please use your own material to follow along. In this video, I'm using an image in Log C color space and have the Alexa rendering view transform applied in the viewport. Now we'll be using the MasterGrade in the effects environment, but these tools are also accessible in other parts of Flame. I also have my scopes up with an RGB parade so you can see exactly what the printer light adjustments are doing. Now printer lights can be manipulated from a grading panel or the number pad on the full-size keyboard. I'll supply the keyboard shortcuts during this video, but the behaviors will be the same with the grading panel. In the MasterGrade controls, the image type is set to the log toolset. I'll discuss the other toolsets later. Now the first control is the Master Brightness control for all the RGB colors. So you press Control, followed by the plus keystroke to increase the RGB by one step. One step increment is one unit on the master slider. To decrease the master control by one step, press Control followed by Enter on the number pad. Holding Control and pressing either plus or enter repeatedly will adjust the overall RGB in whichever direction you choose. As I mentioned earlier, holding Control is a one-step adjustment. If you want to make a half-step adjustment, you hold Shift, followed by plus or enter. This increments the master brightness slider by 0.5. Quarter-step adjustments can be achieved by holding Alt, followed by the plus and enter keystrokes. And finally, the smallest incremental adjustments you can make are an eighth of a step. Hold Ctrl-Alt and press the plus or enter keystrokes on the number pad. Now these shortcuts will be referenced in the docs, but here is a slide of the keyboard shortcuts to remind you of the different printer light keys. Now let's return back to our example. You'll notice that the waveform is just shifting up and down uniformly, which is equivalent to adding or subtracting density on a piece of film. In the log toolset, the step size is one luster point, which for historical reasons is actually half a traditional printer point. If I switch to the scene linear grading toolset and adjust its controls, the step size is 1/10 of a stop, which is about the same size as a luster point in the log toolset. In the scene linear toolset, it is the exposure control that gets modified, which is exactly analogous to the brightness control in the log toolset. Finally, I'll switch to the video grading toolset. Using these controls, you'll note that it works differently and there is no exact analog to the exposure or brightness controls. So the printer lights feature simply applies an additive offset. This is the equivalent to an ASC CDL offset. The step size in video is 0.02. The size of a single step was chosen to allow you to quickly arrive at roughly the desired grade. At that point, the fractional steps may be used to refine your adjustment. I'll switch back to the original log grading toolset. Now aside from adjusting the overall master RGB, you also have the ability to adjust the color balance using printer light shortcuts. And to maintain a very high level of flexibility, you have two styles of adjustment. The first style is called the luster style. The printer light adjustments only affect the specific RGB channel. For instance, to add more red into the image, hold one of the keys to choose your step adjustment and press the numlock button on the number pad. Pressing 7 on the number pad will decrease the red in the image. As a side note, you can see the color wheel changing as you adjust with printer lights. To see the numeric value of the adjustment, hold Alt and swipe below the color wheel to reveal the RGB sliders. As long as you choose your step adjustment hotkey first, the printer light adjustments on the number pad should work quite fast. Now press forward slash or 8 to increase or decrease the green. And finally, the blue adjustment is just as important, and this is mapped to asterisks and 9 to increase or decrease the blue. This is the individual channel adjustment, and once again, this is called the luster style. The second style of adjustment is called the flame style, and this yields a slightly different result. So as you make printer light adjustments to a specific channel, the other channels also adjust in the opposite direction. For example, for the one step adjustment on the red channel, I hold Ctrl and press 4 or 1 to increase or decrease the red. The red channel goes up and down, and the green and blue channels do the opposite, so as to minimize the overall brightness change. This is a big time saver if you want to favor one channel over another without having to adjust each individual channel. So the luster style only affects the channel you adjust, whereas the flame style relatively adjusts the other color channels as part of the printer light adjustment. For the last two keyboard shortcuts, to manipulate the green channel using this style, you hold a step adjustment keystroke and press either the 5 or 2 to adjust the green channel. And finally, to make any adjustments to the blue channel, you can use any of the step adjustment keystrokes and press 6 or 3 to increase or decrease the blue channel. Once again, here is a slide showing the keyboard shortcuts, and this is also referenced in the Flame documentation. Printer light adjustments are all about speed, accuracy, and flexibility, and now you have them at your disposal in Flame. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2019.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.